Raspberry Pi started out as an initiative to make programming accessible to people that do not have a lot of money to spend on computers and software. The idea was to create a low-cost educational computing platform to allow anyone to learn computer programming. When the first Raspberry Pi was launched, it became an instant hit as it offered a means of building a cheap multimedia server. Since then, the Raspberry Pi has evolved quite a bit and several million boards have been sold worldwide. So, if the Raspberry Pi is not a pastry, then what exactly is it? The Raspberry Pi is a single board computer, which means that it can function without any external peripherals like a keyboard or a monitor. But it is also powerful enough to be used as a computer to do, for instance, word processing on. Because the Raspberry Pi can work standalone and is inexpensive, it is a great board to put in a box and use it for one specific task, like a multimedia server or as the brains for a robot or a drone. For this reason, the Raspberry Pi has been adopted by both hobbyists and professionals, and it has found its way into many different projects and products. Contrary to commercial laptop computers that usually run Windows or Mac OS, the Raspberry Pi runs Raspberry Pi OS, a flavor of Linux. However, the operating system is not pre-installed, and there are many other operating systems that can be used instead. For instance, Android, Windows 10 IoT, OpenELEC and LibreELEC, and Ubuntu and many more all run on the Raspberry Pi. The multimedia server was probably the application that laid the foundations for the success of the Raspberry Pi, as it generated a huge demand for boards. Education was its original destination, and students all over the world now use the board. Many people build retro gaming arcades with the Pi, while others, like me, use it in home automation. Controlling robots and drones is also popular, but it is its usefulness for hobby projects that attracts more and more users. Compared to a laptop computer, the Raspberry Pi is special in that it has no enclosure and lacks a few more things that you would expect, like for instance a power button. Its hard disk is a micro SD card on the backside. This is quite practical as you can reconfigure a Raspberry Pi simply by replacing the micro SD card. But it also makes the system a bit slow and unreliable as SD cards break easily. The Raspberry Pi has the same dimensions as a credit card, even though it seems much bigger because it's about 20 times thicker. The heart of the Raspberry Pi is a powerful chip from Broadcom, similar to those found in smartphones. It has dual-band Wi-Fi and Bluetooth Low Energy, Ethernet, USB 3, up to 8 GB of memory and a USB-C based power supply. The Raspberry Pi features a gigabit Ethernet and USB 2 and USB 3 communication ports. It has a combined audio-video connector, a camera connector, two HDMI ports and a display port. Last but not least is the 40-pin extension connector that can be used to plug add-on boards on or to connect to homebrew hardware. The camera connector is popular as it allows the Raspberry Pi to see. With the Pi getting more powerful with each new model, the cameras that can be used become better too. This brings us to the different Raspberry Pi models that are around. Today they can be divided into four groups: Model A, Model B, the Zero and Compute modules. The type on the upper left is the original Raspberry Pi, and this shape has been abandoned. The Raspberry Pi Model A is the second board that was released. Model B came first. Model A does not have Ethernet and it has only one USB port. The extension connector has 26 pins and the audio and video outputs have individual connectors. Model A evolved to become the A+, which is smaller. This has become the actual Model A shape with its 40-pin extension connector, a micro SD card and combined audio-video connector. There has not been a Raspberry Pi 2 Model A or A+, and today the Raspberry Pi 3 Model A+ is the latest Model A board. It now has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. The first Raspberry Pi that was launched was the Model B. It has Ethernet and two USB ports. Model B quickly became Model B+, which, like Model A+, is smaller and has a 40-pin extension connector, a micro SD card on its backside, and a combined audio-video connector. The Raspberry Pi 2 Model B has a more powerful processor and more memory than the previous Model B+. Instead of a Raspberry Pi 2 Model B+, an update was released which became known as Raspberry Pi 2 Model B version 1.2. It has a slightly more powerful processor than version 1. With the introduction of the Raspberry Pi 3, wireless connectivity was added to the Pi. This model also is a bit faster and has a better power supply, which had always been a weak point of the previous models. Besides offering a bit more processing power, the Raspberry Pi 3 Model B Plus also features gigabit Ethernet and dual-band Wi-Fi. At the time of recording this video, the Raspberry Pi 4 Model B was the most recent model. It presents a major update compared to the previous models, as that it is no longer fully compatible on the connector side. The micro USB power connector has been replaced by a USB-C connector, and the full-size HDMI connector was split into two micro HDMI ports. The Ethernet and USB connectors swapped places. It is also much more powerful, with up to 8 GB of RAM, real gigabit Ethernet and two USB 3.0 ports. The board is available with three different memory sizes, 2 GB, 4 GB and 8 GB. To allow easier embedding of the Raspberry Pi into user applications, the Raspberry Pi Zero board was released. This is a small stripped down Model A and is very cheap as it only costs $5. The Zero W is a Zero with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. When you add a 40-pin header to the Zero W, you get a Zero WH. Finally, there is the Compute Module or CM series. These modules only have a processor and memory and no peripherals, and they fit into a DIMM socket. They are intended for embedding in user applications, and the current model is the CM3 Plus. So what do you need to get started? Well, first of all, you will need a Raspberry Pi 4 Model B, unless you have a good reason for wanting another model. Add to this a micro SD card of 8 GB or bigger to install the operating system on. A 15-watt USB-C power supply is required to power the system, and very practical but not required is some sort of display with HDMI input. Keep in mind that it must connect to one of the micro HDMI ports on the Pi, so an adapter or a special cable may be required too. Finally, although strictly speaking they are optional, a keyboard and a mouse will prove to be very handy too. Once the system is complete, you must install Raspberry Pi OS on the micro SD card. With the introduction of the Raspberry Pi Imager tool, this has become simple as long as you have a good internet connection. Download the tool from the Raspberry Pi website and install it on a computer. Stick the micro SD card into the computer and launch the Imager tool. Select Raspberry Pi OS from the list and select your micro SD card and then click Write. The tool will now download the OS and write it to the micro SD card. This takes quite a while, especially if your internet connection is slow. Note that you have to download it only once, so rewriting the micro SD card or preparing more cards is a bit faster. When sticking the micro SD card into the Pi's card holder, make sure that the card's contacts face the Raspberry Pi's backside. Connect the keyboard and the mouse, also connect the display. Either one of the HDMI ports will work, even though HDMI 0 is recommended for some reason. Finally, connect the power supply. When you power the board for the first time, the operating system will have to do some extra work, making the boot process a bit slower. The screen will blink and flicker a few times, this is normal. The boot process is complete when you see a nice graphical desktop appear. This brings us to the final preparation step, system configuration. A wizard will guide you through this. It will ask for the language and keyboard you want to use, and it lets you set up Wi-Fi. Once an internet connection has been established, the wizard proposes to update the system. If you accept it, you may be in for a long wait, especially if your internet connection is slow. When the wizard is done, you will be asked to restart your system to apply the new settings. When the Raspberry Pi has rebooted, you are ready to go.